You know, it's funny in theater how things come full circle. So when I was a really, really, really little girl, I did my first ballet performance, and my mom thought I was going to be a princess and wear a beautiful pink tutu, but I was a witch. And the second year, she hoped maybe I would be a beautiful little princess in a pink tutu. And we did a production of The Wizard of Oz, and I was a brick. So years later, I got to be, again, a witch in Wicked. And here's Wizard and I. Did that really just happen? Have I actually understood this weird quirk I've tried to suppress or hide? Is a talent that could help me meet the wizard if I make good. So I'll make good. Once I meet the wizard, once I prove my worth, then I meet the wizard, what I've waited for since birth. And with all his wizard wisdom, by my looks he won't be blinded. Do you think the wizard is dumb or like Munchkin, so small-minded? No, he'll say to me, I see who you truly are, a girl on whom I can rely. And that's how we'll begin, the wizard and I. Once I'm with the wizard, my whole life will change. 'Cause once you're with the wizard, no one thinks you're strange. No father is not proud of you, no sister acts ashamed. And all of Oz has to love you when by the wizard you're acclaimed. And this gift or this curse I have inside, a girl who is so superior, shouldn't a girl who's so good inside have a matching exterior? And since folks here to an absurd degree seem fixated on your verdigris, would it be all right by you if I degreenify you? Future is unlimited, and I just had a vision almost like a prophecy. I know it sounds truly crazy and true, the vision's hazy, but I swear someday there'll be a celebration throughout Oz. That's all